Hello all, this is Tarina, and I am going to get started on this layout. I'm not sure you can see it very well, but I will put hopefully a large photo of it up on the screen for you. And I am doing a page for the Close to My Heart Heritage Scrapbooking page, and this is my husband's grandmother and grandfather, and so this is the picture I will be using. And I have lots of stuff that I'm looking to use. These and flowers that I've made, and these were done with the basic hearts thin cuts die set, and then so, and there's a whole bunch of the Hello Lovely, which is, this kit is the Hello Lovely kit, and I might be using the compliments that go along with it, so we'll see. So for now, I'm going to be doing a lot of stitching and a lot of cutting, and then we'll figure out the rest after that. That's the basis. So I guess we'll just get right to it. I'm using the craft cardstock from Close to My Heart for the background. I'm not exactly sure how that's gonna work. I kind of want to use the dark, but I kind of want to use light. I think the dark will bring in the dark from the photo, which will kind of balance it out. So I guess we'll see. Let's see here. Alrighty, so what I'm going to do first is I'm going to cut off the branding strip. And then I'm going to cut 6-inch piece from this one, 6x12. Ooh, maybe I won't. I'll have to go this way. I don't know if that was even better, any better. Oh, ho, sweet. All right. All right, and then I'm going to cut that in half, so we'll have 2 6-inch pieces in the blue, and I'm going to cut the zip strip off this, branding strip, whatever you want to call it. That one's nice. And I'm going to cut a 6-inch strip. And then we'll have 2 6-inch pieces for that color as well. Alright, so now we're going to... Okay, so let me see how I do this. I'm going to trim off, I think it's 3/4 of an inch, if I remember right. That just seems so small, doesn't it? Okay, 3/4 of an inch it is. And then flip it over and do 3/4 of an inch. Let's hope this works, because if it doesn't, I'm going to be... Okay, that one is... Actually, that one would work just fine for the shorter sides. Okay. So, let's see. 3/4. And 3/4. All think I will want this to go this direction, so I'm gonna go for 3/4. I think it'll be fine. And 3/4. And 3/4. So technically these should be, the larger squares should be 5 3/4. 5 1/4, I mean. There we go. If I get my numbers right, that'd be great. Alright. And then I will need to put this up. I'm gonna lay this out real quick just to see if I like it, because I don't know. We're going for small outer edge, and I will be distressing the edges of these, so it should make it smaller, and then we'll do these smaller as well. So, which will go down here, and then this one will go here, this one will go here, like that, and then we'll do the same here, and here, and here, and here. I think I actually like that. Okay, so I am going to begin. Actually, how do I want to do this? Alright, what I'm going to do is I'm going to start. This is going to take a bit of time, so I will fast forward for you guys through this. Actually, I think what I'll do is I'll just pause it for you and skip through it after I show you exactly what I'm going to do. What I'm going to do is I will be using this. However, at the moment, I'm going to take this. And usually I would run this through my sewing machine. However, this time I am going to actually stitch by hand. I'm going to go through these and actually just poke the holes in each one all the way around all of my pieces. And then I will stitch it with white thread. I don't know about that, because I need a little bit of room for... Okay, well, I guess we'll go for that then. So, I am going to do just this one piece all the way through, and then I will pause for you guys so that you're not having to wait on me. No, these didn't line up perfectly, but that's okay. doesn't need to be perfect. I can't believe I'm saying that because I love things to be perfect, if possible. However, I have a lot to get done. So, that's what I'm going to start with. I'm just going to do the holes real quick and then set that aside. And I'm going to scrape the edges and then also round the edges. And if I need to trim down the thickness of the smaller rectangles, I can do that to the rest of the pattern paper so that it all fits. Because I want some space in between each of the pieces, much like a quilt, which is where I got the inspiration for this page. And then I'm going to take, let's see, I think I want to do a hole. Nope. I'm going to break it up. I'm going to take some twine. And I'm going to Alright, so the twine, which that would work out just fine. Alright, so this is the Whisper thick twine. And I don't know if you can see that. But there it be. And so I'm going to separate this after I think I'm going to pull about a yard off of there. And then I'm going to split it up. So this is spun in two pieces with a whole bunch in between. So there's a lot of thread here in one piece. So this is how I'm going to take mine apart. I've embroidered for many years, so this is the quickest that I've found to get things apart, straightened out. It naturally wants to curl, so if you just kind of straighten it out, it'll go pretty easily. All right. So now, on top of that, I'm going to take it down a little bit more because there are, let's see, we've got 8 strands here, looks like. Maybe 10 strands. It looks like we've got about 10 strands in here. So I think I'm just going to do half because I don't want it a really strong accent. I just want it there a little bit, and I'm going to do it the same way that I did before. Just pull it through. And I can use that for the next one. Okay, and now I'm going to get the end wet. Yes, it's kind of gross, but that's alright. And I'm going to, I don't know if I want that big of a Alright, I'm going to use a needle, and I'm going to stick it through there if I can. That is quite a bit for this size of a needle. Also, trimming the edge off, or the tip off, makes it nice flat. thread to go in there if it'll go. It may only want, looks like it only wants 3 to go in, but I I'm just going to go with a bigger needle. Not a lot bigger, but a little bigger. Alright, just a little bit bigger of a needle and it worked just fine. Okay, so what I'm going to do is I'm just going to start sewing. Through the back to the front. And I'm going to take this off on the back. Here with just some spare tape, washi tape that I have lying around. And then let's go through. You always want to go gently because if you don't go gently, you'll end up with a knot and you won't be able to get the knot out. So. And I've never done it with this type of thread, so I guess we'll see how this goes. Alright. Alright, this is getting quite messy. And this is all right. And this is the edge that I'm going to end. And I will finish these last ones up so that it's not quite so long for you guys. Honestly, if I were to... Oops, I skipped one. That's all right. You can always go back. Recover it. There we go. I think if I were to do this with just my regular stash, I have a large amount of embroidery thread from my grandma who passed, and I would definitely use it because this is gonna get caught a lot. But for the look and the guidelines that I've got to go by, this is perfect. And I love that the color matches the whisper that's already in the paper as well. So that's awesome. And it's a little bit of guesswork already done. I will do this inside here, and then I will pause it for you guys and get it all done. I would have to say, embroidery is quite therapeutic, much like crafting or scrapbooking, which is probably why I enjoy both of them. I remember laying on my grandmother's lap and just had my head on her lap, and she would embroidery. She had her embroidery hoop, and there was always something she was doing, pillowcases or things for gifts, all kinds of things. And I remember laying there and watching her embroidery. And it was one of my favorite things to do with my grandma, was just to lay on her lap and watch her embroidery. I'm sure for some people that sounds kind of lame for a kid, but I still love watching it. And it's funny because my kids like to watch when I create things as well. Alright, so that's the one side. And I'm gonna put you guys on pause. Alrighty, I'm back. I have all of these done, and they are all stitched. There we go. And I've even done these, which they do look a little bit raggedy right now, but I think once they're adhered down, they'll be fine. And I am going to place these out here. I'm hoping this works out. With just a little edge around each one. But we'll see, I suppose. Nope. One of them's not gonna work, but that's okay. Alrighty. So I'm gonna have to zoom out a bit. A lot of bit. Alright. There we go. Alright. So I think I actually like that. The center will be covered. And I think that will give enough room around each one to have just a little bit of color. So I think I'm just going to adhere this down. And I'm just going to use my ATG for this. If it doesn't work, then I'll use something a bit stronger. I'm going to try to keep the, try to keep the edge. There we go. I'm just going to do these two. I might need a little bit thicker of a adhesive. I will have a mini tutorial on how I do the flowers for this layout, and that should be up either before or just after I put this one up or I post this, so hopefully. My goodness, that's squeaky, isn't it? Hopefully that's not sticking to it. It does not want to stick to that tape. Nothing. You know, I really do enjoy the embroidery, and I think I may start incorporating that into my work a little bit more often. It's something I really love to do, and I love the way that it turns out when I'm done doing it. I was very tempted, actually, to embroidery these little dots here, but and the blue ones. Just to give it a little bit more depth. But that would take a lot more time. So. Okay. And the last four. Alright. Let's hope this works. My tape again. It really likes that tape. There we go. Hopefully that worked. Okay, so see how that works? This center here will be covered. In the original quilt, it had, or quilt block, it had the opposite squares. So this, or this color would be here, and this color would be here, and then this color would be here, and it alternated there. But I don't need to worry about that part because that's going to be covered by the center and the photo. And I'm not sure if, so these are the flowers, and I have to make a few more, so I am going to be doing a small video tutorial on how I managed to do these using the thin Basic Hearts thin cuts. So let's see. Let me set that up there for now. So this one, we're going to do it this way, right here. And then we will have, I think I'm going to put this one up on dots or something. I meant foam tape. I really want it to kind of stand out so that I can, and I'm not sure how I want to trim down the photo either, so. Those are things I gotta figure out as I'm going, because, you know, I just don't like to plan everything, because if I plan everything, it's harder for me to adjust when things don't go the way I'd planned. So, I think I really like that. It's so pretty. Okay. So, I think that's where, this is where I'm going to pause again. And I'm going to come back once I've trimmed down my photo, I think. And finished up my flowers so that I can organize where I want the flowers and everything compared to the picture. So I will see you in a bit. Right, so this is kind of how I decided to lay it out. I did have this back there, and it just seemed so stark. I know that these are white, or the flowers are white, but it still just seemed, the picture just seemed to really be too much for the page. So I decided to go ahead and pull another page out of the Hello Lovely kit, and it's this burlap here that's behind the photo. I don't know if you can see the pattern on that there. It's really pretty, and it helps blend or bring in or tie in the photo nicely. So I decided to go with that, and what I'm going to do is I'm going to adhere this down first. And I'm going to adhere it. Here in the center, and I want it to be right in between these two. All right, and I'm going to go ahead and trim those off. Okay, and that will be covered once I have that frame on there. All right. this one, I really want to be, there we go. This one I'm going to do on foam. Tape. Okay, maybe I won't. I think I'm going to do that now. I liked the idea before, but now I'm just not sure. I think I like it without it. Okay, so I'm going to go ahead and use, where did it go? I will be right back. Hello, I'm back. Okay, so I am going to go ahead and adhere this down. Hope it doesn't dry faster than I can stick it. Did a little bit of coverage there. There we go. And that'll be covered up anyway, so I don't need to worry about that. Okay. And then I think maybe I'll do this up on foam squares. Foam squares, but foam tape. Sorry about that. And in my photo, or my layout that I've created, let's see if I can get that brighter for you guys. In my layout that I created, there we go. Yeah, it's pretty simple with the flowers and all, so I'll just stick it down and fiddle fart with those for a little bit, and then see how that goes. Part of me wants to stick it right in the center, but the other part of me just wants it kind of to the upper right. I think I'm just gonna go there. Just a little off there. And then I think, I don't remember exactly how I had these. And let me see if I've got a photo going. Oh boy. Of course I would have to. There we go. Okay, so that's how I had it. Oh, I had it turned. That's why it looked so... Okay, so I'm gonna pop... Oh, maybe I won't pop this up. go. Luckily, I didn't push it down very hard. I thought I did, but whew, I'm thankful I didn't. Okay, so we're going to turn this. Ooh, we're going to turn it the other way. Like so. There we go. Staying. Okay, let's see if I can get this all straight here. There we go. It's totally crooked. I have to fix it. I can't help it. Have to. Have to, have to, have to. Semi-straight would be good. Okay. Things like that just drive me nuts. Get an idea and it comes out all crooked and wonky. Okay, let's see. Alrighty. I think we're gonna go ahead and stick that down, and I think I'm going to go ahead and use the adhesive dots. Alrighty. This one's going to go like so. Actually, I think, yeah. Here we go. And let's see. I just noticed that I'm not talking very much. I do have a lot of thinking going on. There we go. I'm going to trim off all of these just because it's easier to place them underneath. And then we'll do these as well. And I love these adhesive sticky things. And these ones, these little flowers here, they were made with just a single layer of the little hearts that I made these out of. So it's pretty easy to put them all together. It's just taking time to do it and getting sticky glue fingers, of course. This one's gonna go in. so. And this little flower is going to go right on top. If I want that there or not. I do feel the need for some greenery right there. I just don't know what kind. That looks good. Sure, why not? There we go. And then I will take this and try to fluff these up without ruining them, because I just made them not that long ago, so they may not be dry fully. Alrighty, and everything stuck down, and I just undid the foofing. Okay, so that would be my layout. I hope you enjoyed my process. A little crazy wild all over the place, but I am also going to be putting a tag on the back side in a little pocket that has the information about, you know, what I just thought about. Okay, anyways, that talks about who these people are, which I stated in the beginning of the video that they were my husband's grandparents. And so I am also going to have that information on the back, like their birth dates and all that. I'm going to add some bling because I can't help myself. And I just don't know how I want to do it. And I don't know which ones I want to do. It's kind of like the grays. The enamel gray enamel gems. I really like the gray enamel gems. And I also like the gold. And gray and gold generally don't go together. So I'm not sure what I want to do. I think I'm going to go for gold. Don't know where exactly, but I'm going to do it. Alright, so let's say here. And here, or here, or here, there we go. And then we're going to go for some silver, I think, because these do have little bits of silver in them. These are the bitty sparkles, and they are so adorable. I got a couple different packs just because I love them. I really do. Oh, come on. They are quite tiny, just so you know. Let's see. I just don't know where else I would want one. You know what? I'm just not sure. I'm gonna stick it right there. See? And I just go and change the whole entire thing, don't I? Like that? I think so. Alrighty. And that would be that. So now I'm done. Okay. So. And that would be it. Thank you guys for watching. Bye. Once I got my layout done, I realized that the photo mat was from the Artiste cartridge from Close to My Heart, and it's no longer offered, so therefore it's not current. Part of the guidelines were for the challenge were to be current product, and so I went and I looked through my artistry book and I found this frame, and it worked perfect. So I just kind of wanted to show you guys, just because it was complete, it wasn't really complete, and that either way it turns out great. So I will talk to you guys later.